We've just come off the summer season, so now we're aiming for the winter, ready to peak for the qualification races and then ultimate peak in performance for Lillehammer 2016. So a normal training day for me, I train 6 days a week. I do, at the moment, 3 gym sessions and 3 running sessions. I believe the gym work that I do is extremely important to monobob because we're pushing the sled on our own. The sled weighs quite a lot, so as well as being fast, it's really important to be strong as well. And also, with all the gym work we do, not only are you increasing strength, but you're also increasing muscle bulk, so you're putting on weight. And the heavier you are, the less weight you need to add to the sled to make the maximum weight. So a lot of the work we do is all power-based, so it's a lot of Olympic lifting, power cleaning, snatch. We do a lot of squatting, and we also do some upper body stuff as well, so it's important to have all over strength. But there's a main focus on the lower chain, so legs, and also having a strong chest for when you push. When we train at the track and push the sled, it's extremely important for us to practice the start. In Great Britain, we don't have an ice track, so we're already at a disadvantage to other nations. They can spend time on the ice, time driving, practicing. So we like to train here on the track. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to achieve the fastest start possible. It's been proven in bobsleigh that the faster you are at the start, the faster you are at the bottom. And the normal equation is the 1/10 at the start is worth 3/10 at the bottom. And we know if we can achieve the fastest start, we give ourselves a good chance of winning a medal. When we're practicing the starts, our main focus is to get the technique absolutely spot on. We know if we can get the technique right and the hit right, and it can be powerful off the block. And we work specifically on the hit and making sure it's powerful, and the first few steps are all powerful and going in a forward motion. And we know the faster we get to the 15 clock, the faster the start will be. When we're on the push track, you can definitely feel if your strength work in the gym has been paying off, especially in the first 15 metres, because the stronger we are, the easier it is to push the sled over the first 15 metres. My dad competed in 1998 in Nagano, in 2002 in Salt Lake City, and 2006 in Turin. Having somebody in my life with that kind of experience and that level of competition has really helped me as an athlete. Because when I'm struggling with something or when I'm not entirely sure what I'm supposed to be doing, then it's really good to be able to talk to him and ask him about his previous experiences and how I can use that to learn. Going to the Youth Olympic Games would mean a lot to me. It'd be absolutely a massive achievement to represent my country and Great Britain on that level. Although it's a Youth Olympic Games, it doesn't matter. It's still an Olympic Games and there's still Olympic medals to be won. So that level of competition and representing the country in that competition in particular would mean a lot to me.